Mr. Speaker, on behalf of the thousands of hardworking teachers across the Commonwealth, I want to recognize this week as National Teachers Week. The origins of National Teacher Week are murky. However, teaching is one of the oldest professions. Around 1944, Arkansas teacher Mattie White Woodridge began corresponding with political and education leaders about the need for a national day to honor teachers. Woodridge wrote to Eleanor Roosevelt, who in 1953 persuaded the 81st Congress to proclaim a National Teacher Day. There's much dedication that goes into the planning, grading, teaching, and maintaining a positive relationship with students and parents. At times, being an educator seems like a thankless job. Everyone has good days and bad days. However, teachers must power through their own struggles while also managing the behavior of students having a particularly difficult time at home or at school. Teachers and professors bear the heavy burden of educating future generations. They continue to find ways to teach and interact with their students while also attempting to navigate the social issues and traumas of our time, more now than ever as we navigate through a pandemic. Let us remember what John F. Kennedy noted several years ago. He said, "There's an old saying that the course of civilization is a race between catastrophe and education. In a democracy such as ours, we must make sure that education wins the race." Mr. Speaker, I am sure we can all remember a teacher who made a difference in our lives. Today, we take a moment to recognize that important teachers have on students every day. And I want to just take one moment to recognize my mother, Pearl Knott, who taught elementary school for 20 years at the Sharpsville Area School District, and the teacher that really had an impact on my life, Bob Stahl, who was my middle school teacher and then later my ninth grade basketball coach. And he was that man in my life in the school system who put his arm around me. He said, "You can do this," and gave me the confidence to succeed. We all have a teacher like that in our lives that we should say thank you to today, and that's why we proclaim National Teacher Day. Thank you, Mr. Speaker, for this opportunity.